Early in June, here at the United Nations Geneva, the board of the UN Conference on Trade and Development organized a general debate and interactive dialogue. The Holy See contributed its Catholic faith-based perspective to both events.
A decade after the global financial crisis of 2008, financialization, or the growing influence of financial markets on the material well-being of most of humankind, remains a core obstacle to progress, to reform, and to the promotion of integral human development.
Doesn't the achievement, though, of integral human development start with the recognition and implementation of the most basic human development, namely the right to life?
Yeah. I would say, certainly, you know, it's a complex thing. I think one of the good things of the United Nations, which are, I would say, often also criticized for having too many subjects, is that we are coming back to more and more essential questions. That's a right to life, right to existence, right to education.
Okay, the church does its best. But, you know, when we're talking about right to life in particular, if I look at the United Nations, the question of abortion.
We, in the coming anniversary of the Charter of Declaration of Human Rights, we are going to present as a mission of the Holy See exactly considerations on this subject: abortion, euthanasia, so many other things. It means if we take human being as autonomous and independently left in the hands of those who can decide about its future according to pragmatic theories, we are in front of society, it will be completely different. So it's always the same thing. You go to the weak. We have to stay with the weak. And this is the vocation of the church. And this is the vocation of the Pope Francis. Nothing else. How to do, we'll see. We do what we can.
The UN Conference on Trade and Development was founded on the belief that developing countries needed more support and commitment by the international community to achieve inclusive and sustainable development.
Mr. President, the expansion of international trade was understood not to be a goal in itself, but a means for ensuring stability and peace and to promote an inclusive human development.
Why, in your opinion, do not have all people equal opportunities for their human development?
Let's say only one thing. In today's world, we all speak about the growth. But if everybody asks himself, how is growing your salary? Even in developed countries, salaries are not growing. So it means all this money is going just to one part of the society, and the other has probably not enough participation. And we are talking now about the developed world, the world that has not major problem. You can imagine what does it mean for the world that's underdeveloped and in big troubles. So we have to correct continuously the history, we have to correct the economy, and the church is one of the players, especially through its moral and ethical considerations.
In your opinion, do Catholic business people apply their faith effectively in their business?
There are two things which must be said. First thing is this general conviction of the Church, expressed through the teaching, through the documents, through the Pope, which is somehow an appeal. And it appeals to everybody, certainly good for the Catholic more than the others, but also the Catholics. But then, as you know, in the functioning of economics, the economic functions as it functions. And so it means everybody has to find the slot that it can correct and modify.
So the change starts with yourself, then it goes
then on. Other, you know, this is the problem. Now, if you don't change, then nobody changes. Mm-hmm. If you, and this is, everybody knows today that we have to do this a kind of new, I think the beauty of modern life, of being interconnected, of sharing and being encouraged by the others.
Very good. So this was part one of our little interview. In part two next week, we will talk more about this and in particular about the denial of ethical principles, especially in the financial markets.
According to the Holy See, in these troubled times, strengthening the role of the UN in trade and development to promote a more just global economy is essential.